your boy Big T, going solo today. You know, Big T King Seas, Spreaker.com/Extreme Radio. Extreme Radio, tune in. Welcome this morning. going over some games last night. The game last night between Golden State and New York last night. 125-111. Playoff time is kicking. It's closing in. Second half of the season. It's time for everybody to step up and show up. We'll get those seedings in. Who will do, I know a lot of teams will be fighting for the 8th seed, so see what happens on their part. But, hey, the world champs last night played in New York. Madison Square Garden did the thing. Klay Thompson, 26 points, 5 assists, 4 rebounds. They win 125-111 over New York. New York, like we said, the rebuilding stage. Porzingis is hurt out for the year with the torn ACL. Need talent down there. So, I think me and C's were talking about one of our shows not too long ago that you haven't seen that talent in New York since the Patrick Ewing days, John Starks, people like that, Charles Oakley. It's been a while. New York is the mecca of sports. I don't know why they have been rebuilding for these last couple of years, and I guess they thought Melo would answer. Find out that wasn't the answer. Porzingis is that talent, but sometimes you put too much pressure on the big men, and they can't hold up to what they can produce. So hopefully they can get it together and produce something down there that can make it work. Like I said, Klay Thompson 26 points, Kevin Durant 22 points, Steph Curry 21, big three. Draymond Green 10 points, 6 assists. JaVale McGee. I always love JaVale McGee's talent. Even with back in the days when he was at Denver. Washington. I think he started out with John Wall. I thought JaVale McGee, he's the athlete, big man that can jump, go get you a dunk for anywhere. I always saw that with Rasheed Wallace back in Carolina. He can just turn on you, just go for alley and just dunk in your face. I always loved it about him. I wish they would use him more, but they like Jordan Bell coming on. He was coming on good. Got hurt, so I guess they go just slowly push him back in the rotation. But hey, we'll see what happens. So shout out to JaVale McGee. On New York side, how they looked last night was, let me see, try to go back here, but hey, we ain't gonna worry about New York. Lakers beat Atlanta, last night, 123-104, Kansas on Brandon Ingram had a big game. He had a double-double, 21.6 assists, 10 rebounds. The kid is coming on. Like Magic said, that's his talent. He's excited about Brandon Ingram. He sees a Kevin Durant in him. I can agree with that. His shot got better. I would just wish he played the Carolina and not the Duke Blue Girls. Shots fired. Brandon Ingram, like I said, 21.6 assists, 10 rebounds. Pretty good game for him. Like I said, he's coming on, a lot. Lonzo Ball had a pretty good game. Probably one of his best games, efficiency-wise. 13 points, 5 assists, 7 rebounds. I think it was 4-for-4 from the field. Isaiah Thomas, 13 points, 5 assists, 2 rebounds. Kuzma, 10.3 assists. This Lakers team. I would talk about this Lakers team. But like I said, Lonzo Ball, Kuzma, and this team is young. Zubiak been coming on lately. I don't know why they haven't been playing him that much this year, but I guess when they found, you know, they got him in now, that he's been doing really good. It's a missing piece they need. They have been, I think, two or three games winning streak right now. Julius Randle, since he's been starting lineup, been excellent. Double double for him, also 19 points, 10 rebounds. I think that makes you, you know, efficient, keep him in that rotation instead of the trade talks that they were talking about or the offseason moves that they're going to make. Like, you know, what do you think about keeping Randle now with Paul George maybe coming or LeBron maybe coming and stuff like that? So you're looking at, you know, the team they see. Because the Lakers, right now the Lakers can be looking at, hey, next year they want to be a contender in their Western playoff spot. They don't want to be the team that looking back and stuff like that. They are now 26-34, not too bad, but at the same time for a young team, but at the same time, you know, what can you make out of? Because, like I said, when Magic took over, Magic is a winner. He is, look at what he did to when he bought the team, the Sparks. The Sparks went to the championship the first year. Went back to the championship again. Magic just a winner. They lost to Minnesota this year. I'm sorry, but the first, you know, 2 years ago they won the whole championship in the WNBA. So Magic is a winner for everything that he do. So you got to look at, he's going to put the team together. And you hear the talk over the years. He talked about how he felt about the Lakers organization, but things that the Bus Taylor was doing, the guy the son was doing, Jim Bus was, he felt like he was sabotaging the team instead of trying to make teams better, not going after key free agents. He lost Dwight Howard back in the days because people didn't want to play with Kobe, things like that. So, hey, it was a big mess down there. Hopefully, Magic cleaned a lot of this. Going to clean a lot of this up. I think Luke Walton. I hear the rumor about Luke Walton not being the coach. Luke Walton gonna be a great, tremendous coach. I think he's, you know, he gonna put the talent together. You just got to listen. Coaches, these kids, these now young men. I can say this, young men these days, the money overrule powers everything about listening to your coach and what he needs to do. If you, hey, I'm this certain person, you know, I don't have to listen to you. And come on, I think Luke Walton is he's an excellent young coach. He's he's been through the trenches. Look at that, he won championships with Kobe. He won championships at Golden State. Hey, you know, I like, he got an excellent coaching staff with Brian Shaw and the guys that have been there in the championship. So, shouts out to the L.A. Lakers. So, moving on. Let's take a little break. Real is on the rise. J-Real. Extreme Sports with your boy Big T.
The real is on the rise, fuck them other guys. Why y'all niggas looking all stupid and surprised? Money on my mind, money on my menu. Niggas know I'm on my grind, so you know what I get into. Dealing with my brothers, I ain't fucking with you suckers. Swear to God, y'all niggas out here know that y'all just can't touch us. Bricks, that's the click, haters on our dick. Give a shit, every time I turn around, I give them shit. Niggas know just how it go. Blowing on some other shit, bout to fucking blow and take off like the mothership. They don't understand it, they be underhanded. I don't think I give a shit until the day I'm apprehended. Lyrically I'm hard, lyrically it's soft. Swear to God I fuck around, I have to knock you haters off. Haters get tossed, deep in your bitch. Bitch, I ride with the starting five, they be on the bench.
The real is on the rise,
y'all niggas head. Set up on my grind, tryna get this cash.
The real is on the rise,
I said I can't escape. Talking about the life, but I live this way.
all a shame. They really think I'm playing, but it's not a game. And all these other rappers sounding all the same. I ain't got no time for that. I be where the grind is at. So if you tryna look for me, then you know where to find me at, dawg. Why these niggas hating on our cause? Put my dick up in your bitch and let her hate my balls. They say you only get one shot, but I got a full clip, so my spittin' won't stop. I'm the best, fuck the rest, cause all you niggas suck. I advise you keep it moving like a U-Haul truck. I've been spittin' this for years, and y'all niggas just started. I'm shittin' on you rappers, and it smell like you just farted. That's just how it go, these niggas are slow. Me, myself, I'm chasing dope, while you out here chasing hoes, yeah.
Welcome back. That was Real is on the Rise by J Real featuring my boy Melly Mel. Extreme Radio with your boy Big T. Extreme Sports with your boy Big T King C's. Welcome back to the program. So keep it moving. Last night the Pelicans and the Phoenix Suns. Anthony Davis 53 points last night, beating the Suns for the straight wins over the Suns. Oh, their sixth straight win. It like seems like the Pelicans are coming on very, very quickly. Anthony Davis, you know, what we were talking about year before last, healthy. He could be one of the best players in the NBA. He has proven that. So, but it's just staying healthy. Like I said, 53 points last night, 18 rebounds, 3 assists. You know, great, great performance. Putting just the talent along with him and keeping him healthy can make that team go a long way. And people have, you know, I would not go trade that talent. You hear the rumors about Anthony Davis going to the Lakers. You had rumors about people inquiring information about him. What can they get for him? Anthony Davis is one of the big time talent. He can be one of the LeBron James talents of the NBA if healthy. So I would not push for he's your franchise. That's what I'm saying. He's just your franchise. He's one of the best talents out there. So they are coming on very good right now. They can be a scary team in the playoffs, you know, come April, you know, late April. So, hey, let's see what happens on that front. So, 53 points last night from him. On the other side of Phoenix Suns, Devin Booker is one of the top right.